The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf.
We're really happy that we were able to get back there, identify the rocks and the mineralization at surface and sample that and actually get higher results now with a maximum of 8.1% U₃O₈. So very happy with that. The rock types there look fantastic.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Standard Uranium Vice President of Exploration, Sean Hillacre. Sean, very good to speak with you. You've announced some of the highest uranium grades ever reported at Corvo. What do these results tell you about the project's potential, and how do they compare with historical findings in the area?
That's a great question. Yeah, we're really excited about what we saw here. We got out to the project, boots on the ground, did a prospecting, sampling, mapping program earlier this summer. So we got those results back and we were obviously hopeful. The highest grades historically at the Manhattan showing, the highest U₃O₈ values were about 7.2. So we're really happy that we were able to get back there, identify the rocks and the mineralization at surface and sample that and actually get higher results now with a maximum of 8.1% U₃O₈. So very happy with that. The rock types there look fantastic. We've got, you know, in the release, it talks about different rock types and different kind of deposit models, plus the added bonus of rare earth element concentrations as well. So really interesting geology there, seeing these mineralized faults at surface and being able to sample those and repeat those historical results and ground truth them is really exceptional. So we're very excited to go get drills there.
Your team also uncovered new radioactive showings and confirmed mineralization across multiple areas, Sean. Can you explain the geological significance of these discoveries and what makes Corvo such a promising uranium target?
That's right. So, you know, we identified a lot of different radioactive showings that were previously undocumented. This project has been worked a fair amount over the historical exploration up until 1980. That was when the last drilling was done. And then there's been a little bit of modern exploration on the ground there. But the fact that we were able to get out there and find numerous other radioactive showings at surface in, like I said, a kind of a different plethora of rock types, being, you know, pegmatite uranium versus metasedimentary hosted and ortho gneiss hosted. It really speaks to like the complexity of this area. The structural controls were easily visible at surface, which is exactly what we're looking for. We're looking for structurally hosted, basement hosted uranium here on this project. So confirming those and, you know, getting a sense of how many radioactive boulders are on the project as well, you know, speaking to the glaciation in this area and the possibility for potentially multiple deposit types and instances of mineralization across the project is really promising.
Sean, you've mentioned plans for a ground gravity survey in December and a drill program in early 2026. What's the key objectives of these programs and what would success look like for Standard Uranium?
Great question. So we've, you know, since we got our hands on the project and staked it, we partnered with Axiom Exploration earlier this year. They flew a brand new electromagnetic survey across the project. So we've really confirmed and expanded our strike length of these conductors on the project, which are essentially the plumbing system for the uranium. Like I said, we're looking for basement hosted, structurally controlled, high grade uranium here. So confirming those conductors is kind of the first step. And now we want to go back and refine our targets through this gravity survey. So we'll get that going as soon as the lakes are frozen, you know, end of November, early December here. The snow is starting to fly in northern Saskatchewan already. So that's good. We'll get the crew out there. And what they'll do is cover the entire, you know, almost 30 kilometers of strike length here with a gravity survey. So what that does is unlocks this data layer that kind of shows us where alteration halos might be along that strike length to really pinpoint where we want to drill. So that identifies density lows, which are usually related to uranium deposits here, or a good indication that hydrothermal activity has been happening. So that'll help us pinpoint our targets ahead of pushing a road in and drilling for the first time in about 40 years on the project since 1980, right? So excited to get in there. And speaking about the logistics of the project as well, the highway goes right through the southeastern corner of the project, so we'll be able to access that, keep our drill costs down, and start testing some of these targets for the first time.
Well, Sean, I hope you'll keep us updated on your progress with that. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Absolutely, my pleasure. Look out for news. There's going to be lots happening here.
We'll be looking out for that. Sean Hillacre, Vice President of Exploration at Standard Uranium.
The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf. It is for informational purposes only and does not constitute investment advice, an offer, or a solicitation to buy or sell any securities. Viewers should conduct their own research and consult a qualified financial advisor before making investment decisions. The views expressed are those of the speaker and do not necessarily reflect those of Proactive Group Holdings, trading as Proactive Investors, or its affiliates. No responsibility is accepted for any loss arising from reliance on the information presented.